bound it down, brother. Back to the shop.
Here's the deal. I made a bet with my rally buddy, Jay Rick.
What are you doing in town, man? Come on.
He gave me 70 grand to deliver a tricked out Smokey and the Bandit Trans Am. Deliver it in 6 days and I collect a $40,000 bonus. On top of that, if I slap a Burt Reynolds autograph somewhere on the car, I grab another 25 grand. Quicker than you can say, what's your 20, good buddy? I bought a car and I'm pulling it in the Gas Monkey driveway. We got the Bandit Trans Am bought, and now we got a whole lot to do and not enough time to do it. Special delivery for Sue.
Rachel arrived, I walking on my tree. He interrupted me.
What up, Sue?
Hey, what's up?
We got Trans Am for you. What are you messing with over here?
Some leaf.
Do you eat
some
it?
Leaf? Yeah.
Is it poison?
Yes, it's poison.
How bad poison?
I want to poison him. No, I want to poison you.
See, he's my taste tester.
So he got to get the dye first. What happened to Aaron? I don't know. He might be a stomach pain.
This is a 77 Trans Am Bandit car. The interior is really nice, as you can tell, but what we want to do is jazz it up. You know, nice leather, maybe suede.
Suede
all black.
In here?
Yep. Black. And then all you're going to have left is the top of the door panels, which we'll bring you, and the headliner. Yeah.
Smokey and Bandits. Bull Rhino played that movie. Rachel cut it like Bull Rhino. He liked to drive fast.
So we're looking at 36 hours. I need this back.
And he want me to do it 36 hours? No. So all this C and
door panels. No, seats. I don't know about the C thing.
The seat?
Yeah.
Yes.
36 hours. And yes. Gonna cost you $3,600.
Come on, don't make me pay $3,600 for this. I'm on a tight budget and tight time frame.
Okay, I meet you halfway,
$3,000?
Yes.
Deal. You got 36 hours.
Thanks, sir, we'll see.
Bye.
35 hours and 59 minutes now.
Bye!
What do you think? You like them or no?
Oh, I like the wheels.
I wish they had come gold.
Yeah,
I guess
me
they
too.
Were on back order, weren't they?
They don't have them. So nobody had gold ones right now. In fact, we wanted the 18s, but time, budget problems. But year one had the 17s, so we got these. But they only had the gray ones. And since I knew a painter and a shop with a paint booth, I figured we could handle up on it. I know it's going to be a pain in the rear. I know that. But it was this or nothing, and there wasn't any other option, so it's
this. It won't be hard. Just time-consuming, taping it up, but...
Oh, yeah, but I think, I mean, yes.
I'm hourly. I don't really care.
Well, that's right. Once it's done, it'll be okay. And the other thing is the headlight bucket. It's the only thing outside the car that's painted gold, too. So
wheels
we'll go ahead and
buckets.
We'll go ahead and re-hit these. Okay. So we got the tires here for it, and we're ready to go. So, I mean, the car looks great. If you can work on this today and get these things done or as close as possible, that would be great.
Okay.
So we got 8 hours. Think we can do it? That's 2 hours a wheel.
I got it.
All right. Cool.
Later.
Thanks, man.
When it comes to the wheels on the Trans Am, we wanted to go with a little bit bigger one. We went with 17s instead of the original 15s, and we wanted gold, because that was on originally. And fortunately, we couldn't get gold wheels, so I was stuck taping them up, and that completely sucked.
I have to tape up everything that's been polished and powder coated, so I have to sand in between each one of these. I was having a hard time. I got some little quarter-inch tape and trying to go around it. It took me like 45 minutes to do a little section. So I went over to 360 wraps and had Tommy put this on there and then shrink it down. Not that bad, still time-consuming, but I just got to cut the holes out now, so a whole lot easier than it was going to be, and it's going to keep me from going cross-eyed trying to stare at making sure all my lines are straight. So we got them sanded in the booth, prepped, and we're also doing the headlight bezels just to make sure everything matches right. I get this done, soon we can be done with it, and those guys can do whatever they want from there.
So we're halfway through our Warp Speed Bandit build. The suspension's in, the rear end squared up, and we really haven't hit any major problems. But if we're gonna keep this thing on schedule, we're gonna have to get the brakes finished about as fast as it took Bandit to grab lunch.
Pump it. I am pumping. Unfortunately, some things can't be hurried, and bleeding brakes is one of those.
Hold it.
Holding. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Pump it.
we have to relieve every micron of air out of the brake line because air compresses.
Pump it, Tom.
And in a hydraulic system, if you got air compressing, the hydraulics ain't doing what hydraulics do, which is push. Right now, we do not have a firm, hard pedal. We have a pedal, but it's kind of Hey, the pedal is getting better. And when all the air is gone out of it, we should have a firm, hard pedal. There we go. We got a good brake pedal.
Now that the brakes are done, we get to do the fun stuff. No, not that.
Hey, buddy.
Outstanding.
This car's over 40 years old. I guess the guy that ordered it wants it to handle like it was born yesterday. Well, once we put this overdrive tranny in, this baby's gonna scoot a lot faster in lower gears.
You need to come down just a smidge.
I gotta go up on my side first.
There we go, we're golden.
It's good. Well, we got the transmission in Trans Am. Everything's looking good. Only thing we lack now is putting drive shaft in it, wheels, tires.
So we just got our drive shaft back. We just sent it out and had it cut down 4 inches because our new transmission has an extra gear in it, which in turn makes the case of our transmission longer. All right. She is in. I got it back in and everything's perfect. Spline's in good, correct seating depth, length, everything's great.
Well, we welded everything up. Heck, I think we're ready for some exhaust and put it on the ground and see if it's gonna run.
A hell of a lot more load than the other side.
So how's this going?
It's going pretty good. I built.
You know, some builds at Gas Monkey Garage seem like one problem after another, but the Trans Am, smooth sailing. And it's a good thing considering how little time Richard gave us on this build.
Well, it looks good. Heck of a lot closer than we were 2 days ago.
Great. I like it.
And as long as the motor doesn't the bed, so to speak, we'll be all right.
Tomorrow, the guys still have to get the exhaust on, get the motor fired, and get things buttoned up so we can get it over to Sue's and start the interior. It's gonna be a big day, but by the end, should have the car off our hands.
So this morning, we're gonna get the exhaust and a few other odds and ends on this Bandit Trans Am so we can get the motor fired up and get it sent on its way. We get to see if we met the Bandit standards. It's kind of exciting.
Well, that ain't exactly what we're after.
I'm watching oil pressure flex way 60 to 80, 60 to 80, 60 to 80. Me and Tom, we got the car set down on the ground, ready to go over to Sue's. We heard a little bit of a noise. Well, it became a problem real quick. So now me and Tom, we're pulling the oil pan off of it to see if we can't figure out what the noise is.
Hey, look at this.
We found plenty of problems, not just one.
Look at the scoring on that.
We think we see a possible crack in it, a chip in one of the cylinders. A lot of the cylinders have scoring, with just big look like a tiger was trapped in the bottom of the cylinder trying to claw his way out.
You got more grooves inside of a dime, huh?
Yeah.
What a freaking mess.
And an issue like this would generally stop a build for a couple days. Problem here is that we're supposed to be delivering this car in 2 days. What, you're expecting a happy ending? You wouldn't get that halfway through a movie. You're not gonna get it here.
So I gotta get this car decaled and over to Sue's in like the next 2 hours. And then she's gotta get the interior.
You need the decals in 2 hours?
Yeah, like quick.
Okay.
You can do it, no problem.
I got it.
Get it done, two hours.
No problem.
What are you here for, sir?
The motor's shot. I mean, it really is shot. It runs, but it won't stay together much longer. Whoever had this, I think, knew that. The pan had been off recently. So this won't make it to New Orleans. If it do, it'll be on its last leg and falling apart.
I cannot believe this. I don't know how I can make my time frame. So there you have it, Murphy's Law. If something could go wrong, it will. 1 minute I'm ahead of schedule, and suddenly I've got no engine. So now I'm sweating it because Jay Ricky said 3 o'clock, that's his deadline, and we gotta get a motor in the car. And I don't know how we're gonna pull this off, and if I don't, I'm out $65,000. I need a beer.